few years have been men that are in a group called the North Texas Catholic Brothers for Christ. And they, every year for the last 7 years, have put on a spring conference, and it's been at various locations. Normally 800, 900 men come out, and it's just an awesome opportunity for men to get together, kind of learn male fellowship, male spirituality, go to mass, go to confession, and hear some outstanding speakers. And this is the first year that they are branching out. They're going to have a fall event. And it's called Experitus. First time they've done a fall event. It's going to be Saturday, October 14th. And there's going to be an English track, and there's going to be a Spanish track. And there's going to be one outstanding speaker. And he's actually a returning speaker because he spoke at one of the spring conferences a number of years ago. I do not think he is somebody that you have not heard of. His name is Jesse Romero, and he's going to be coming in doing the English and the Spanish event. And I must say, I'm on the NTX CMC website, and because of the hurricane stuff, they, I think, temporarily have taken the details off. But you can register for this. I understand that the English event is filling up very quickly. Spanish event, if you're bilingual, still has some tickets left. But Jesse joins us now to talk about this event and what's going on October 14th. Jesse Romero, good afternoon. How you doing?
Great, Dave. Thanks for having me on. And I can't wait to see my buddies out there from Texas. I love going out there preaching the gospel.
Yeah, and a few are better at doing it. I know the Holy Spirit is working through you very powerfully. And like I said a moment ago, I know a number of these guys, and they're just tremendous men. And I know when they're looking for something, especially somebody who can come in and speak in both languages and fire guys up, I know you were the top of the list. And so what is it from your understanding that they're asking you to do on October 14th, so when you come in here for these two sessions?
Well, I think one of the things that they're asking me to do is to energize men to start having a devotion to the rosary, to start praying the rosary. And I have an angle that I share with men that I think is very effective. Personally, my life was saved during the Rodney King riots here in Los Angeles, I think back in 92 or 93. As a result of praying the rosary. In fact, I got my story, it's on the internet, because on YouTube it says how the Blessed Virgin Mary saved me from the gang beatdown. Long and the short of it, I was surrounded by 150 gang members. I'm a lone cop, no radio connection. All the patrol cars are grounded. LA is burning from one place to another, and there's no communication. And I said, okay, I've got a gun and I've got a rosary. I've got 150 gang members with baseball bats that want to kill me because I work for the sheriff's department. Mm. So I started praying. And I can just tell you, I'm alive as a result of... that's probably the talk I'm going to give at the conference, because when I share it with men, I'll tell you, I'd be dead right now if it wasn't for the rosary. It wasn't my gun that saved me and all the bullets I had in my war bag. It was the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary that I believe blinded these thugs. And as a result of that, I was let go and set free. But again, I have a lot of stories like that. I think God has given me the ability to put meat to the gospel. In other words, it's good to share doctrine. That's really good. People need to hear that. But I always back up doctrine with things that have happened to me or that I know about that are nothing less than miraculous. And guys look at me, they say, man, this guy's not some seminary brat. This guy's an ex-cop, and this guy's an ex-fighter. And this guy's talking about real hands-on stuff of what the rosary did for him when he started praying it in this certain situation. So, you know, that's the angle that I take, Dave. And here's also another thing that I think is very important for men. And it seems to help. I tell guys, look, the rosary is a weapon. And I know it's a weapon because it's what I've seen in my life. And I'll share some of those stories of what I've seen, what it's done in my life. But I fashion the rosary personally like a 50 caliber machine gun. Mm-hmm. And every time we're saying the Hail Mary, you're saying the two most powerful names in the universe, Jesus and Mary. And what you're doing is you're laying down a canopy of protection around yourself and around your family through the rosary. And also the rosary, because it's meditation. We know from the Desert Fathers back in the 4th century, they say that demons cannot be in the presence of somebody who meditates. And the Rosary's meditation on the life of Jesus par excellence.
Yeah, that's awesome. And, you know, it's going to be a week exactly after the Feast of the Holy Rosary and the anniversary of Lepanto back on, whatever year that was. And I know that this is just an incredible time. We've spent the last, 5 months or so focusing on the message of Fatima, Our Lady coming down. I mean, how many times does she have to tell those shepherd children to pray the rosary every day? And still, most of us, including myself, don't do it every day. And so I'm so glad that you're tying in the rosary, because I'm sure the Lepanto victory is something that you have perhaps spoken on or done a little study on. So,
and most Catholics don't know about it.
Yeah. And
as I hear your
story about being surrounded by these gang members, obviously outmatched, even though you're a tough guy, but there's no way you're going to take on 150 guys, whatever you said. Same thing happened to Lepanto. I mean, the Christian army was well outnumbered by the Muslim forces, weren't they?
Absolutely. 3-1, men and boats. And a similar thing happened. The Pope at the time was a Dominican. He was called a rosary crusade in Europe. And all the men that were in the ship as well, all the crusaders, they went in there with a sword, with a shield, and with a rosary in their hand as well, rosary in their pocket. And it was just, they were just storming heaven with prayer, because on a human level, there was no way they could have won the Ottoman Turkish Empire. But once again, the Blessed Virgin Mary just intervened, and the rest is history. If it wasn't for that victory, Europe would have fallen into Islam. Europe would have become Islamicized, and guess what would have happened to America? This probably as a result of the Puritans coming to the East Coast and the Catholic Spanish conquistadors coming through the Southwest. This would have been a Muslim country.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, gosh. And Our Lady protected us from that. Speaking of Jesus, and Jesse Romero, he's in California now, but on October 14th, Saturday, he's coming to North Texas. And the North Texas Catholic Brothers for Christ, who have been putting on men's conferences now for 7 years, and I've been to all of them, and they've been fabulous. In fact, Jesse was here 1 year speaking and gave an outstanding talk, and now he's coming back. And ntxcmc.org is the website where you can find out more about this. Like I mentioned a moment ago, the North Texas Catholic Brothers for Christ went down to Houston, and they helped out in Corpus in Houston. So there's a lot of information about that on the website. But they're getting the information back up so you can register. But I do know it's $25, which is a steal, because the English session is going to be from 8 a.m. to noon that day on Saturday, October 14th. And then there's a Spanish session that evening from 6 p.m. to 10. You're going to get breakfast at the English session, dinner at the Spanish session, and in 4 hours of evangelization for $25. And so this is a really, really good opportunity for men 18 and over to go to this event. And it's going to be at the DFW South Hilton Garden Inn. And so just on the south side of DFW Airport there. So very conveniently located, ntxcmc.org. And Jesse, when I hear you on the radio, when I hear you talk, you're fired up, you don't mince words. And I know that a lot of us guys, courage is a difficult thing to have, as you're we're looking at some of the challenges in our day and all the assaults on our faith and our family. And I know myself, I struggle, because we kind of want to be liked, we want to get along. What's your response to that, to guys who may just be struggling with Christian courage these days?
Well, see, that's why it's important to be part of a good men's group, because, there's in the book of Proverbs 27, I think it's verse 11, it says, iron sharpens iron, and one man sharpens another. And that's, Dave, I used to work with the gang unit for many years over in East Los Angeles. The power in gangs and in subversive groups and in, anarchist groups, KKK, Black Lives Matter, Antifa, the power, and the Hells Angels, I mean, I could go on and on. If they run in packs, there's the power's in, the strength is in numbers. And Catholics, we have to realize that, because that's not a bad thing that these evil men do. Hells Angels, Mongols, vagabundos, again, KKK, Crips, Bloods, Mexican Mafia, et cetera, et cetera. They run in packs, and that's where their strength is at. That's why Jesus sent out the apostles, not by themselves. He sent them out two by two. And so it's important for Catholic men to find a good Catholic fellowship, a good group of men, so that you can encourage each other, because that's what evangelization is. we've got to encourage each other in this life to get to heaven, because you can't do it by yourself. St. Paul couldn't do it by himself. He always had a buddy with him, Silas, you know, Timothy, you know, Barnabas. He always had somebody. Peter had Mark. The fact of the matter is, Jesus intended us to be saved corporately, and that's how we encourage each other, by participating in these good Catholic retreats, good Catholic men's fellowship, and staying in fellowship. You got to stay plugged in, because a Catholic man, it would be like a piece of log that rolls out of the chimney. And that log is only going to burn if it's connected with the other log. You're going to burn brightly. But if that log rolls out, it's going to just, it's going to extinguish. And that's what happens to a guy that moves away from the church and moves away from men's fellowship.
Yeah, phone number is 877-757-9424, 877-757-9424. This is the Good News Program here on KTH 910 AM. We're broadcasting across North Texas. Jesse Romero, Catholic evangelist, lives in California, former LAPD officer and also kickboxing champion, right, Jesse?
Yeah, I fought for 10 years, Dave. I was pretty good.
That's good. Well, what have you, you know, I think physical combat, I sometimes have gone and taken little lessons here and there. I'm by no means any kind of black belt, but I think this learning to battle in a temporal sense certainly can be connected to our battle in the spiritual sense, which many guys, many people don't even realize that there's a battle going on because we can't see the enemy. What do you say about that? When you can't see the spiritual enemy, but you have to be convinced that they're still there.
I'm glad that you mentioned that, because most people, here's what I tell guys and stuff, and this seems to register with men. I said, look at guys, 100% of us are going to die. I said, I don't know if you realize that many of the great, Pope St. Gregory the Great, St. Augustine, they say that the moment that we die, demons attack us at that moment most ferociously. That's the most vulnerable point in our life, when we're dying. Well, guess what? Here's the good news. Our Lady of Sorrows, she actually says that those of us that are, and that could be any single Catholic, by the way, I'm just talking about me or you, whoever's devoted to Our Lady, she says in her seven promises of Our Lady of Sorrows, I will defend you in your spiritual battles against the devil, and I will protect you at every instant of your life. And also she says, I will help you against demons at the moment of your death. So let me connect these two things. Okay, Pope Gregory the Great and St. Augustine said, the moment you're dying, demons come after you ferociously, like never before in your life, because that's the last moment of your life that they want to snatch you to hell. Well, the promises, the good news, Our Lady of Sorrows, she says she will be there. Those who are devoted to Our Lady, she will be there fighting the spiritual infernal enemy of ours the moment we are dying. Now, I mean, talk about backup. Talk about, you know, talk about having heaven's army, you know, coming after you and helping you at the moment of your death. They are, again, every one of us is going to die, 100% of us. Talk about spiritual life insurance. I tell people, every time you pray the rosary, what you're doing is you're putting into your spiritual bank account, because the moment you die, you're going to cash in on all that, because Our Lady is going to be out there fighting for your soul the moment you're dying with legions of angels.
Amen. 877-757-9424, 877-757-9424. Jesse Romero joining us here on the Good News Program. Have about five more minutes, and I want to mention also Jen Baugh has entered the studio, and she is the second Monday, I think, of the month. She comes in and does a Young Catholic Professionals segment. She's going to have one. Megan O'Brien is going to be her guest on the phone today. So we're going to learn about young people in this battle to keep our faith and to be strong Christian Catholic leaders as well. Right now, we're talking about an event that is really right around the corner, only a little more than a month away. It's going to be Saturday, October 14th. A week after the Feast of Our Lady of the Holy Rosary, a week after the anniversary of Lepanto, and as we close out the 100th anniversary of Our Lady's parents in Fatima, Jesse Romero is coming in for an event called Expiritus. It's a fall conference in English and Spanish tracks on Saturday, October 14th, and as I mentioned, the The English is going to be from beginning at 8 a.m. and then 6 to 10 p.m. is going to be the Spanish one. Go to ntxcmc.org, ntxcmc.org. And Jesse, I'm sure there's going to be a tie-in with the message of Fatima. We talked about Lepanto. We talked about the rosary. What else from Our Lady's message 100 years ago do you think will be woven into that your presentation that day?
Okay, well, I'll tell you three things that we are experiencing as a result of failing to live out the Fatima message. The five first Saturdays, confession, communion, the daily rosary, penance on Fridays. As a result of the vast majority of us Catholics failing to live out the message of Fatima, Russia has spread her three errors. What are the errors of Russia? Well, Russia was the first country that started abortion. I think nobody can deny that abortion has now been exported throughout the West, especially here in the United States, even in Mexico, a once beloved, you know, Catholic country. What else has Russia exported? Atheism. In fact, the catechism, when you look at the catechism, it says the biggest problem we face in the third millennium is atheism. Where did that come from? Where did that ideology come from? It came from communist Russia. And the third thing that we've seen that's been exported throughout the whole world is socialism, which is communism light, and communism. It's been exported throughout the whole world. You know, it's interesting. A study was done, said only 10% of Catholics, get that, 10% of Catholics in the United States have a devotion to the rosary or try to pray the rosary a couple of times a week, okay? So that means that 90% of Catholics in the U.S. have completely failed to embrace the Fatima message of praying the daily family rosary. Dave, we get what we deserve. We've been given God's peace plan. We haven't fulfilled it. Now, there's still time, obviously. You know, we can still make up for lost time. But those are some of the times that I'm going to make. This is why we have what's called the culture of death. It was here because we as Catholics have failed to live the message of Fatima's peace plan.
Yeah, amen. And I just was visiting Jesse's website, and there's more details on his website, jesseromero.com, about the event. Again, Saturday, October 14th. And if you like what you hear during this brief interview with Jesse, it's going to be expanded. It's going to be 8 a.m. to 12 noon in English, and then 6 to 10 p.m. Gosh, you can do both of them if you're bilingual. Hilton Garden Inn, DFW Airport South. That's in Irving. And the main local contact, by the way, is Dr. Kyle Eberline, and his email, kmeberline@msn.com. Again, probably the easiest thing right now is go to jesseromero.com, and he has a calendar of all his events, and go to the October 14th one. Jesse, we are about out of time, but I'm very grateful for your time this morning, and we are very eager for your arrival next month for these two events. And thank you very much. Anything you want to, we've got about a minute left. Anything else you want to tell our listeners before we let you go?
The only thing I want to tell everybody out there listening, just remember this, that life is short, death is for sure, sin is the problem, and Jesus is the cure. And last thing I want to say is this, there's 50 beautiful states in this country. Hey, man, the only state that you don't want to live in is called the state of mortal sin. Guess what state we all want to live in?
State of grace.
State of grace.
Yeah, amen.
All right?
Amen.
Pretty simple. All right, thanks, Dave.
All right, Jesse. Thanks so much. God bless you. And thanks for all you do. Jesse Romero, again, guys, sign up. And if you're a lady listening and you have a husband or a father or a brother that is 18 or over, have them sign up for this event. I am planning on being there for the English one. I wouldn't get a whole lot out of the Spanish due to my limitations in understanding Spanish. But anyways, go to ntxcmc.org, ntxcmc.org. Thanks to Michael Rourke and Kyle Eberline and all the men who are putting this on. Those guys work tremendously hard to spread the gospel to men here in North Texas.